You go to the doctor and he gives you 12 milligrams of radioactive dye. After 10 minutes, 5.5 milligrams of dye remain in your system. To leave the doctor's office, you must pass through a radiation detector without sounding the alarm. If the detector will sound the alarm if more than 2 milligrams of the dye are in your system, how long will your visit to the doctor take, assuming you were given the dye as soon as you arrive? So to model this exponential decay, we have a choice of using this exponential function or this exponential function. This first exponential function is actually easier to use if we're given information about the half-life or doubling time. But since we're not, we're going to go ahead and use this function here, where p of t is the amount after time t, p sub 0 is the initial amount, k is the continuous exponential decay rate, and t is the time. So going back up to our problem, if you receive 12 milligrams of radioactive dye when you go to the doctor, that means you have 12 milligrams of dye at time t equals 0. So p of 0 must equal 12. So 12 is going to be the initial amount, or the value of p sub 0. And after 10 minutes, 5.5 milligrams of dye remain. So this means p of 10 must equal 5.5. And since 12 is the initial amount, or the amount when t equals 0, we know that p of t must equal 12 times e raised to the power of kt. Notice how when t is equal to 0, we would have 12 times e to the 0, and e to the 0 is equal to 1, so the function value is 12. And now using p of 10 equals 5.5, we can determine the value of k, or a continuous exponential decay rate. So p of 10 is going to be equal to 12 times e to the, since t is equal to 10, the exponent is going to be 10k, and this must equal 5.5. And now we'll solve this equation for k. So the first step is to isolate the exponential part. So we'll divide both sides by 12. So now we have e to the 10k equals 5.5 divided by 12. And now to solve for k, we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation, apply the power property of logarithms, and then solve for k. So we're going to have natural log e to the 10k equals natural log of this fraction. Now on the left side of this equation, we can apply the power property of logarithms, which means we can take the exponent of 10k and move it to the front. So we would have 10k times natural log e equals natural log of 5.5 divided by 12. But natural log e is equal to 1, so this simplifies out. So to solve for k, we divide both sides by 10. So now we'll go to the calculator and determine this approximate value. So we'll have natural log of 5.5 divided by 12. I'm going to divide this by 10. Notice how the value is negative, which is a good sign because we do have exponential decay. It's also important that since this is going to affect the exponent, we want to include several decimal places. I'm going to round this to 6 decimal places. So k is going to be approximately negative 0.078016. Which means the exponential function that will model the amount of dye in your system will be p of t equals 12 times e to the power of negative 0.078016 times t. And now to finally answer this question, we want to know when the amount of dye in your system will be equal to 2 milligrams so that you can leave the doctor's office. So we want to set p of t equal to 2 and solve for t. So we want to solve the equation 2 equals 12 times e raised to the power of negative 0.078016 times t. So again, the first step is to isolate the exponential part. So we'll divide both sides by 12. So we have 1/6 equals e raised to the power of negative 0.078016 t. And now we'll take the natural log of both sides of the equation so that we can solve for t. So we'll have natural log 1/6 equals e to the negative 0.078016t. And now we can apply the power property of logarithms, meaning we can take the exponent here and move it to the front. So we have natural log 1/6 equals negative 0.078016t times natural log e. Again, most textbooks don't show this natural log e because it is equal to 1. So to solve for t, we'll just divide by the coefficient of t. So now we'll go back to the calculator one more time. So we have natural log 1/6 divided by the continuous exponential decay rate. Remember, the time is in minutes. So if we round this to the nearest tenth, this would be 23.0 minutes. So the doctor's appointment will take approximately 23 minutes, which, as far as doctor's appointments go, this would be pretty amazing.